At 11 years old, I'd already been to the boys' home.
It's a story of forgiveness, hope, and healing. And it's a story that hopes to inspire.
Like I said at some of the interviews, I've got to concentrate on why I'm doing this. You know, so, you know, what they say about if you know your why, then that's a good start.
In July last year, Whamoana Luafutu spoke at the Tulo, our Pacific Voices hearing, regarding the abuse he experienced in state care in the 1960s.
Everybody's a clean page, and we're all born in innocence, you know. And what was written on my page by going into those homes made me the way I was when I came out. That was just total rejection of everything about this world.
And now, film director Nina Nawaluwalu has joined forces with Luafutu to piece together a film which documents his journey in state care called A Boy Called Piano.
For people to actually open themselves and allow the public to look into their lives is the most courageous thing. It's like anything. There's ups, downs, this, that, but there's a bond of trust between us all, and it's a privilege to have that trust, and I don't take that lightly.
One of the things I always worry about is looking back and going, man, I should have just done it. It's healthy, it's healing, and it's deep for us. You know, music is deep for us.
As the film unravels themes of abuse and neglect, it also shines a light on the journey within the Luafutu family, who also play a big part in the project.
So it's been a long journey, you know. It hasn't been just the film in that, like, 2019, first time I ever heard that my grandfather was in the boys' home, was at Water State. Same year I found out what happened there and what it was. And to hear that truth and hear what he went through and, like, lived his whole life hiding from us, you know, it's been remarkable.
Once I saw my father got up there quick because he's a natural performer, but then when I saw my son just naturally progress, I was like, wow. I became easier and I just thought, well, no, this is an actual path for our family. What was scary at the start and a lot of pressure, it took a lot of more pressure off because we shared the load and we shared the truth.
As the film progresses across the country, the cast and crew hope it will help foster change in our communities.
My advice is just love your children and try and understand where they're at and be supportive of their needs. Everything I do now, I believe I'm on a mission. I believe God had a plan for my life, you know, because, man, I've been through a whole lot of sticky situations and I'm still here at 70, and I'm glad to be part of this whole thing.